escorted to the ring by the CEO of Bolin Services, Kenny Bolin. He brings to the ring 242 pounds out of Monterey, California, your role model, Rico Constantino. And his opponent.
What a test for Rico Constantino, only 4 days away from the last dance as he meets a many-time former NWA World Tag Team Champion, a man who helped revolutionize tag team wrestling, and who's been recognized by fans and wrestlers alike as one of the greatest of all time. The sellout crowd here at the Davis Arena, a tremendous ovation for the man, beautiful Bobby Eaton.
233 pounds out of Huntsville, Alabama, beautiful Bobby Eaton!
Well, Bobby Eaton in recent weeks has had his problems with Rico and the prototype and that fat round mound of sound himself, Kenny Bolin. And Bobby chomping at the bit to get a hold of Rico Constantino. Rico on the bicycle right now, trying to stay away from him.
Ooh, we're underway. Robert Briscoe calling for the bell. Circling each other right now. Of course, Bobby, a fan favorite for years and years. He's going to hear a lot of the accolades of the crowd. Right now, he's also putting Kenny Bolin in his place.
That's right, Bobby. Oh, wait a minute. Rico on top of Bobby. He jumped him right from behind as Bobby was trying to tell Robert Briscoe to keep Bolin out of the way. But there's a reversal. And Bobby Eaton with the elbow on Rico, the role model. And folks, while we have a chance, we might not in just a few seconds. We'd like to remind you that this Wednesday, from 2 to 3 p.m., Six Flags, Kentucky Kingdom, Mick Foley, Kurt Angle, The Big Show, and Mark Henry appear. Six Flags this Wednesday afternoon as they get ready for the last dance. You're going to want to be there. Bobby Eaton up to the top. My God, with that knee drop right across the chest on Rico Constantino. Rico rolling to the floor. Bobby Eaton, one of the deadliest, one of the best off the top rope in the history of this business. And now Bobby, down to the floor. Oh, he just nailed Rico with that big right hand. Oh, Rico with a thumb in the eye. He put a thumb right in Bobby Eaton's eye.
I really hate this turn.
No, wait a minute. Oh, he hot-shotted him right into that concrete pillar. Oh, this is ridiculous. Rico just hot-shotted Bobby head first into that concrete pillar. Now Briscoe's got Rico back in the ring, but wait a minute, Bolin is dangerously close. Oh, Rico's got Bobby by the hair. I'll tell you, it's going to be a different type of situation. Wait a minute. Bobby. Jeez. He just threw him right off the ring apron into the concession stand right here at the Davis Arena. There's Bolin.
Jeez.
There's Bolin all over him. Oh, for heaven's sake. I was about to say it's going to be a different type of situation this Wednesday night when it's Rico with Bolin in his corner against Randy Orton and the Cowboy. Bob Orton Jr. will ride again this Wednesday night, and he'll keep Bolin from sticking his big fat nose into things.
Getting him back into the ring, Rico Constantino following beautiful Bobby in. Briscoe finally able to get these guys in the ring, get this thing back under a little bit of some type of control. Meanwhile, Bolin trading jabs with some young lady in the front row. Constantino right now thinks he's having his way with beautiful Bobby, but you start thinking that way about the beautiful one, buddy, it could come back to haunt you.
Bobby Eaton will be one of our legends this coming Wednesday night. He was a big favorite, or should I say he wasn't a favorite. Either way you want to look at it, as a member of Jimmy Hart's first family in the Gardens years ago, but now, wait a minute. Bolin all over Bobby Eaton, choking him again. And Bobby Eaton later to gain greater fame as one half of the Midnight Express, a tag team that was very near and dear to my heart. He revolutionized tag team wrestling in the 80s. Oh, this is ridiculous. Briscoe has got to keep an eye on this thing. Bolin and Rico have been tag teaming practically all over Bobby ever since the start of this thing. And wait a minute. Dean, I'm getting word we're hearing from the director that there's some kind of trouble in the parking lot area behind the Davis Arena. As Bobby Eaton into the concrete again, we're going to try to break a camera loose and try to get some kind of a report. We understand there's a disturbance in the parking lot. After this match, we'll go to that. But right now, Rico, a senton bomb over the top rope, right into the ribs of Bobby Eaton. Eaton, the new assistant trainer here at OVW, at the OVW Training Center.
Oh, man.
And now Rico, once again, all over the top of Bobby Eaton. Oh, for heaven's sake. Bolin keeps running his mouth. Oh, there's Bobby. He came from downtown Alabama with that one. A right hand up under. Oh, and there's another one. You heard the smack of the flesh and the bone. Bobby Eaton fighting back in the corner. Fires again at that deadly right hand. But Rico staying on his man, Rico.
Oh.
Believes that he is the perfect athlete, the role model for everyone to follow.
Come on, Bolin.
And he's got the prototype and studies. But here's Bolin again. This is ridiculous. They have double-teamed Bobby Eaton throughout this entire contest.
How in the world's he even able to get a breath? I mean, every time that Rico's walked away from him, Bolin's been on top of him, choking him, hitting him, doing something. Look, right now, Constantino calls himself a role model. Youngsters, if you're out there, Rico Constantino is no role model for you to be following.
Well, and of course, Rico claims that his prototype, as you hear the folks of the Davis Arena, they are firmly in the corner of beautiful Bobby Eaton, who's now been hung out to dry. And Rico claims his prototype is the only human being who's been able to follow his teachings to perfection. But I think that's a very spurious comment at best, is now Rico with a body slam. And once again, going to taunt the fans, but now he's going to the top. Rico at the top with a moonsault. No! Bobby Eaton out of the way. Rico Constantino hit nothing. And now Bobby Eaton has been maligned and beaten and pounded and choked and abused by two men. But he has a chance to get even here. There's a full slam. And now Bobby Eaton asking the fans, should he go to the top? And he's dangerously close to Bolin, but Bolin, I don't think, wants to mess with Bobby Eaton unless he's already down to begin with. Bobby going to the top. Oh, there's that Alabama jam. The Alabama jam, that leg drop across the throat, and there's the cover. One, two.
Bolin.
What the hell? Bolin just pulled a referee out on the floor. Briscoe up in Bolin's face. There's Bobby. Oh, he just nailed Bolin. He nailed Bolin. Now Bobby Eaton getting back up on the apron, but Rico's got him. Rico, oh, he snapped Rico's neck across that top rope. Now Bobby crawling back in the ring. Bobby Eaton in control again. And Rico, oh, wait a minute. Rico just kicked Bobby off into Briscoe. Bobby went behind going for the roll-up. No! Eaton and Bolin face to face. Rico got a roll-up. No, you can't tell me. Can't tell me. That's a load of crap. He stole that thing. Bolin's on the floor. But Rico's the winner. Briscoe never saw the intervention. Folks, Bolin Services has stolen another one, and we understand that it's Eric Angle that has been attacked in our parking lot behind the Davis Arena. Ron, H2O Waterman, and others are on the scene, and we have a cameraman on location now. Let's take you to the parking lot.